Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. Today I will show you how you can make this beautiful rose. It's easy and quick to make, and I will tell you step by step how you can make it. Here are the materials that I will be using today. We need a 3 millimeters crochet hook and a 2.5 millimeters crochet hook. Scissors, one crochet marker, and hot glue gun. And we also need one of this stem. This one is 10 inches long. We are going to start with a small petal. And for that, I will use a 2.25 millimeters crochet hook. And we're going to start by making one magic circle. And then chain two. The chain two does not count as one stitch. In the magic circle, we're going to make a total of 10 double crochets. One, two, three, four, five. Make five more double crochets. I have 10 double crochets. Now we're going to close the magic circle. And we're going to make one slip stitch here on top of the first double crochet made. And we're going to be hiding this tail along the way. For the round number two, chain two, and again, this doesn't count as one stitch. For the round number two, we are going to be making 10 increases with double crochets. It means that we are going to be making 2 double crochets in each stitch around. And at the end, we should have 20 double crochets. Okay, just continue making 2 double crochets in each stitch all the way to the last stitch. A slip stitch on top of the first double crochet, and now we have 20 stitches. For the number 3, chain 1, and for the number 3, we're going to be working with single crochets. Make one single crochet in the first stitch, and one increase in the next stitch. One single crochet and one increase. One single and one increase. And this is the sequence for the round number 3, making one single crochet and then one increase. At the end of the number 3, we have 30 stitches. A slip stitch on top of the first single crochet made. I place one marker here, count 9 stitches to the right. We have here 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and 9 stitches. Okay, for the next round is going to be the number 4, chain 1, go back to the same space and make one single crochet. And we're going to make a total of 9 single crochets. Okay, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and 9. Chain 1. Single crochet in the next stitch, chain 1, single crochet in the next stitch, chain 1, and single crochet in the next stitch. And this is how you're going to be working all the way to the marker, making one single crochet and then one chain. Then remove the marker. And we're going to finish making one single crochet in the last 9 stitches. Slip stitch to join, one chain, and we are done. We need 3 of these small petals. Okay, next we're going to be making the big petals. We need 3 as well. For that, we're going to start the same way as we did for the small petal with one magic circle, chain 2. And then we're going to be making 10 double crochets into the magic circle. I have 10 double crochets. Close the magic circle and we are going to make the slip stitch on top of the first double crochet. For the round number 2, we're going to be making 10 increases with double crochets. Start with chain 2, go back to the same space and make 2 double crochets. 1 and 2. Now we're going to continue making 2 double crochets in each stitch around. At the end, we should have 20 double crochets. Slip stitch on the top of the first single double crochet made, and we have 20 double crochets. For the number 3, chain 1, and we're going to make 1 single crochet in the first stitch, 2 single crochet in the next, 1 single crochet and 1 increase. One single crochet, one increase, and at the end we should have 30 stitches. A slip stitch on top of the first single crochet, chain 1, and for the number 4 we are going to be making 2 single crochets and then 1 increase. And 2 single crochets and then 1 increase. 1, 2 and 1 increase. For the round number 4, we are going to be making 2 single crochets and then 1 increase. And at the end, we should have 40 stitches. Slip stitch to join. And now we are going to count 11. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, and 11. And we are going to place the marker here. Count 11 stitches to the right. Okay, for the last round, it's going to be the number 5. Chain 1. Make 1 single crochet in the first stitch. And we are going to continue making single crochet until we have 11. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, and 11 single crochets. 1 and 2 chains, single crochet in the next stitch. 1 and 2 chains, single crochet in the next stitch. 2 chains and 1 single crochet. 2 chains and 1 single crochet. And you are going to be repeating this all the way to the marker. I will remove my marker and I will finish making one single crochet in the last 11 stitches. I have 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11 slip stitch to join, one chain, and we are done. You need to make two more of these petals, and this is how they look. Okay, for this part in the leaf, we are going to use a 3 millimeters crochet hook, and I will start showing you how to make this part. We are going to start by making 4 chains, 1, 2, 3, and 4. Make one slip stitch in the first chain. The chain two does not count as one stitch. And in this space here, we are going to make a total of 10 double crochets. 1, 2, 3, 4. Just continue making 6 more double crochets. Join with one slip stitch here on top of the first double crochet. Round 2, chain 2, and we're going to make 1 double crochet, 1 increase in the next. One double crochet. One increase in the next. And just finish this round making one double crochet and then one increase. At the end, we should have 15 double crochets. Round number 3, chain 2. Go back to the first stitch and make one double crochet. And for this round, we're going to be making one double crochet in each stitch. No more increases. At the end, we should have 15 double crochets. Slip a stitch on top of the first double crochet. And the next step is going to be making 12 chains. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, and 12. Insert the hook in the second chain. Pull up a loop, go to the next chain and pull up a loop. We have 3 loops on the hook. Yarn over and go through all the loops on your hook. Next chain is going to be 1 single crochet. Next 2 chains, half double crochet. 1 and 2 half double crochets. Next 3 chains, double crochets. 1, 2, and 3. We have 3 chains, and in the last 3 we're going to be making triple crochets. 1, yarn over twice and make your triple crochet. Yarn over twice and make your triple crochet in the last chain. Skip the next 2 stitches here, 1, 2, and in the third, make 1 slip stitch. Chain 12, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, and 12. Go to the second chain from the hook, pull up a loop, next chain, and pull up a loop, 3 loops on the hook, turn over and go through all the loops on your hook. In the next chain, 1 single crochet. Half double crochet in the next 2 chains. Double crochet in the next 3. 1, 2, and 3. Last 3 chains, triple crochets. 1, 2, and 3 triple crochets. Skip 2 stitches, 1 and 2, and in the next make 1 slip stitch. You are going to repeat this 3 more times, and when you're done make 1 slip stitch. One chain, and you can cut the chart. Okay, the next is going to be the leaf. We're going to make 1 slip knot on our hooks, and then we are going to chain 10. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10. Beginning in the second chain from the hook, make 1 single crochet, half double crochet in the next stitch, double crochet in the next 2 chains, 1 and 2, 2 triple crochets in the next stitch, 2 times, and make 1 more triple crochet here in the same space. One double crochet in the next chain. Half double crochet in the next. Single crochet in the next. And in the next chain, make 3 single crochets. 1, 2, and 3. We have 3 single crochets, 1, 2, and 3. So place the marker in the number 2. Working in the opposite side, we're going to begin by making 1 single crochet, 1 half double crochet, 1 double crochet, 2 triple crochet in the next stitch, 2 times, and finish the triple crochet. 1 double crochet in the next 2 stitches. 1/2 double crochet in the next. And single crochet in the last stitch. We're going to join with 1 slip stitch here on top of the first single crochet. Round number 2. Chain 1, we're going to make single crochets. 1, 2, 3, 4. Here in the first triple crochet, we are going to be making 1 increase. And then we're going to continue making single crochet all the way to the marker. 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. In the marker, we're going to make a total of 3 single crochets. 1, 2, and 3. You can place a marker here in the middle one. And then we're going to start again making 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. In the next stitch, we're going to make the increase. Okay, then we're going to make 1, 2, 3, and 4. The next stitch that you see here is the slip stitch. It's not one single crochet. So after the last single crochet, this is the slip stitch and the chain one. So go to the first single crochet and make the slip stitch. Chain one, go to the next stitch and make one slip stitch. Chain one and slip stitch. Chain one, slip stitch. Chain one and end slip stitch. You're going to continue making chain one and slip stitch all the way to the marker. I did my last slip stitch here. I will make one chain, remove the marker, make one slip stitch here, one and two chains, go back to the same space and make one slip stitch. Chain one, slip stitch, and just keep repeating the chain one and the slip stitch all the way to the end. And when you're done, just make one slip stitch, chain one, and we can cut the yarn. Okay, now we are ready to start adding the petals here. We're going to start with the small ones. Here is the center of the petal. So we're going to place the stem like this. And then fold it. This next one, we are going to place it right here in front where we finish. Just like that. And for the next one, in front of where we finish here, and we are going to start placing this here. And we're going to, for the second one, look for the middle part here. pressing, let it dry a little bit. And then the last one, we are going to place it right here. And just press and let it dry. If you want, you can cut these ends here. And add hot glue here to this part and let it dry. The next step, we're going to pass this part here. And then for the leaf, okay, the size of your rose is going to be depending which material you're using. For this one, I use a 4-ply yarn with a 2.5 millimeters crochet hook, and for this one it's about 3-ply and a 2.25 millimeters crochet hook. If you want to make your rose like smaller, use a thinner yarn and a 1.75 millimeters crochet hook, or if you want to make your rose like bigger, you can use the same 4-ply yarn, but use a 4 millimeters crochet hook or 5 millimeters crochet hook. Thank you so much for watching my videos, and don't forget to subscribe, give us a like, and share on your social media. Any questions, please let me know in the comments below. Thank you and have a wonderful day.